trains require energy, which they require to consume in order to move. This energy can be provided by onboard energy systems such as diesel, coal in steam trains, and in these days, battery and hydrogen, or electrification. And the two methods of electrification is from a 25,000 volt overhead AC electrified system or a ground-based third rail 750 volt DC system. Railway electrification is extremely dangerous and do not go anywhere near it. The third rail 750 volt system will kill you, and the 25,000 volt AC overhead line electrification system, if you come in contact with it, there won't be much left of you. It's lethal. And also, the overhead electrification is lethal if you go near it. It can arc. The electricity can arc through the air to people nearby. So stay as far away as you can from it, unless you are working in an authorised capacity on the railway infrastructure. You have no business going anywhere near any form of railway infrastructure. It is lethal. So stay away. However, it is an interesting subject. Without any form of energy, the trains won't go anywhere. This video is for awareness only, and it does not give anybody who watches it permission or implied permission to enter or interfere with the railway infrastructure. The railway is an inherently dangerous environment, and this video is not intended also to be a substitution for any form of personal track safety course. As I've said, it's for information only. Please be safe and keep away from the railway infrastructure. A diesel locomotive carries its own fuel source in the form of diesel. And on this Class 57 locomotive, a diesel engine powers electric motors. This train is hauled by a Class 68 locomotive. It's got a non-motored driving cab at the front end, and at the rear of the train is the Class 68 locomotive propelling the train, but controlled by the front end of the train. Diesel multiple units have diesel motors along the bottom of the train. In this Class 185, this is a diesel hydraulic unit, which has got a hydraulic torque converter, a type of fluid coupling that acts as the transmission medium for the motive power for the diesel engine to turn the wheels. But other types of diesel multiple units have diesel engines that create electricity and in turn turn the electric motors for the wheels. Most other trains used on the British Railway network run off electricity. In terms of the voltages used, in the UK, a domestic supply is 230 volts AC. There's two different types of railway electrification. There's a 750 volt DC direct current third rail system, and there's a 25,000 volt AC overhead line electrification system. With any form of railway traction electrification, Network Rail's completely correct mantra is
electrified lines are always on, so always stay off. Either third rail electricity supply or overhead line electrification are always switched on. Many electric multiple units run off DC third rail traction, and an insulated traction shoe on the multiple unit collects electricity from a raised third rail. This is at 750 volts DC. The third rails run either on the inside or the outside of the running rails on which the train sits. And this can be seen via the red lines on the photograph. And here's a closer look at the collection shoe. The third rail sits on top at the end of the sleeper that holds the running rails on which the train rides. So you've got the running rails, the sleepers, and then the 750 volts DC conductor rail sits on top of an insulating pot. Overhead line electrification is energised at 25,000 volts AC or 25 kV AC. I'm no expert on railway electrification, but somebody who is Gary Keenor, who writes the book Overhead Line Electrification for Railways, which can be downloaded free of charge from Gary's website at rcsforrail.com. And RCS, by the way, stands for Overhead Catenary System. Like the Class 68 diesel locomotive, an electric locomotive can propel the train from the rear end of the train or the front end. And on the video you can see a train approaching Stratford Station in London. At the front end is an unpowered driving van trailer, then some Mark III coaches, and the train is propelled by a Class 90 locomotive at the rear of the train. Similarly, with this Class 91, the locomotive is at the rear of the train. And when the train travels in the opposite direction, guess what? The locomotive will be at the front. Electric multiple units do not have one locomotive. They've got multiple engines underneath the train. The electricity is collected from the overhead line system via a device called a pantograph. And here we can see a pantograph in its lowered position. And here in its raised position. The pantograph collects electricity and then transmits it to the train's engines underneath. And here's another look at the equipment that sits on top of the train. In terms of collecting the electricity, there's a contact wire and a catenary wire. The catenary wire supports the contact wire, and the contact wire is the part of the overhead line electrification system that comes in contact and transmits the electricity to the train's pantograph. But the wires are held by various types of structures. We're going to look at three typical types, the first of which is a cantilever. A cantilever is a vertical mast that holds registration arms onto which the wires are clipped. The second type of structure is a portal. This is a structure of two vertical beams and a horizontal beam, and this holds fixed points to which is connected the contacts and catenary wires. And the final type of structure is called a headspan. This is two vertical structures with wires suspended in between them, and the electric, catenary and contact wires are connected to these wires. Headspans, however, are susceptible to high winds and poor weather. If you were to look at an electrification system from above, the wires are not straight, they zigzag between the various structures that hold them, and this is called the stagger. And the stagger exists so when the pantograph runs under them, it doesn't create a groove in the pantograph. Here we can see in an old British Transport film the contact wire zigzagging along the pantograph. There are trains that use various sources of energy, such as bimod or trimod. This class 802 bimod multiple unit can take power from the overhead electrification system, but also has diesel motors underneath for non-electrified sections. This class 769 bimod and trimod unit can run off the overhead catenary system or a diesel engine, and here it is approaching Southport under diesel power. They were converted from class 319 electric multiple units, and some are bimod and some are trimod. And here we can see where the electricity supply comes down from the pantograph on the roof to the traction motors under the train. As some members of the class can be powered from the 25kV overhead line system or the 750 volt DC third rail. So they can either be third rail, overhead line or diesel powered, making them trimod. And look out in the future for more exciting modes of travel, such as hydrogen trains and battery-powered trains.